Hey, I'm Nate Fosaaen. I'm a professional archaeologist currently excavating in northern Texas. I specialize in the archaeology of the indigenous peoples of North America prior to colonization by Europeans, especially in the region that we call the Eastern Woodlands. I've been working in this region for more than 10 years, so I have a lot of experience to draw on with the topics I'm going to be discussing. Now, I know that I've been spending a lot of time in previous videos on the Archaic and the Paleo-Indian periods, so I want to move forward a little bit into the Woodland period. And I'll attach a card up here to the video that explains time periods in North American archaeology because I know those aren't very well known. Now, the obvious place to start for the Woodland period is the Hopewell culture, but that topic is huge and I've been a little overwhelmed by it, so I've decided to do this video first to talk about a contemporary group of craftswomen in the Deep South, the Swift Creek Potters. So I first found Swift Creek pottery in South Georgia, but it's also been found in northern Florida, South Carolina, and a bit of southern Alabama. So in most pre-industrial cultures worldwide, the making of pottery is predominantly the domain of female artisans, and the craft is taught mother to daughters and with some cross-training among aunts and cousins and so on. And pre-colonial America is not different in this respect. This isn't to say that men were never involved in the process of making pottery, but ethno-historically, the institutions of education and training in the making of ceramics is focused on training women, not men. So when we look at Swift Creek pottery, we're most likely examining the work of women. Now, what makes Swift Creek pottery so significant is that it's decorated with impressed stamping. So wooden paddles were made with elaborate designs carved into them, and then these paddles were pressed into the surface of the clay on the outside of the pot just before being fired. And because these paddles were hand-carved, no two stamp patterns are exactly alike. So a fair amount of research has been done trying to match pots with particular patterns across the region. So you might find a piece of pottery in South Carolina that has a certain pattern stamped into it, and then you might find another pot with the exact same stamp in another state, in Georgia or Florida, say, and that means that those two pots were made using the same paddle. So this means one of two things. A single potter could have been moving around the southern coastal plain making and decorating pottery with her particular paddle that she made, or a potter could have traded or gifted the paddle off to someone else at some point, like a daughter who moved away when she got married, for instance, or pots themselves were made and then traded out. And it's most likely that all of these scenarios were happening from time to time across these regions. But in any event, our ability to match paddle designs from pottery across this region allows us as archaeologists to get a sense of how interconnected this region was during the Middle Woodland period. Moreover, because wood degrades, become worn, cracked, so on, we can also see when pots were made with a brand new paddle and then another pot might have been made much later, and we can see that degradation of the paddle. Even if, you know, they've been made 10 years apart, we can see that because the wear and tear is visible in the stamps on the surface of the pottery. Now, we don't know exactly why this pottery style was so important in its own time. Were these pots being traded around and valued as items of trade themselves, or were the pots just containers for something, some particular special trade item? And the elaborate designs were just a form of branding and marketing for whatever these goods were. It's hard to say at this point, but one thing that we can say for sure is that the value associated with Swift Creek pottery was so significant that it has been recovered as far away as the Pinson Mounds Complex in western Tennessee, and that's one of the oldest platform mound sites in the Americas. So I hope you found that interesting. As always, if you have any questions about, you know, this or anything else involving North American archaeology, you can leave those in the comments section. And as always, thank you for watching.